Nobody's going to keep my mask on, not when it comes to the VFI news and Israel in the Middle East, because here today I'm going to bring you the latest and the greatest. Because today we're hearing that Iran's Raisi president says Teheran is absolutely serious about nuclear talks, which are supposed to take place on November 29th. We're also going to look into the response of Prime Minister Bennett, Naftali Bennett of Israel, and see what he has to say about all this. Don't forget, I also want to introduce you each time or every other time to a new song that Batya and I have done, and one that she wrote so beautiful called Hashkifa. That's about the Lord God Almighty on high. And then we're going to talk about Iran's president claiming country's assets have been unfrozen. Who did that? Well, he's not telling and I'm not telling. Last but not least, I want to talk to you about Israel's leading edge technology in COVID breakthrough vaccinations or treatments. And not to leave out that they are now on the cutting edge and leading edge of a cure for Alzheimer's. So stay tuned. This is VFI News. So let's talk about what's happening in Iran and these renewed talks that are supposed to take place in Vienna on November 29th with those nations which were in the original agreement. Who are those nations? Russia, China, Germany, Britain and France, and of course the United States. President Donald Trump pulled out of this negotiated process, which was defunct anyhow, back in 2015. And right now, they are heading for the same mistake they made before, assuming that Iran is going to actually follow this agreement, when in fact, on the side, quietly, they keep accelerating towards the development of their first nuclear bomb. Israel cannot allow this to happen, folks, and our prayers are important not to allow it to happen. It's a deception like we saw with Prime Minister Neville Chamberlain of Great Britain back when he met with Adolf Hitler in 1938. It was only about 6 months later that Adolf Hitler and the Nazis invaded the Sudetenland in the nation of Czech and then on to Poland and several other countries. Well, what does our Prime Minister in Israel, Naftali Bennett, say? Well, he said and stressed that Israel would defend itself no matter what happens in the nuclear talks between Iran and world powers. And this is during a military exercise that was taking place by the IDF in northern Israel on Tuesday. So we have to be really on our watchtowers praying. We are surrounded by security challenges. This is what Naftali said. And the goal is to take advantage of periods of relative quiet to build strength. Therefore, we are preparing for various scenarios, both near and far. Quote, we are dealing with Iran and its affiliates in Lebanon and Syria. No matter what happens, remember, no matter what happens between Iran and the superpowers, and we are certainly concerned about that fact that there is not enough toughness in the face of Iranian violations, Israel will defend itself even on its own. Mark my words, something's afoot. Continuing with Naftali Bennett saying, we are currently seeing Iran's policy within Iran in the nuclear context as well as its strengthening outside Iran and its influence in Syria and Lebanon. The world must act against Iran and Israel must continue to do what it needs in every front in general and in the northern front in particular. So, quoting our defense minister, Gantz, Benny Gantz. So, who knows where things are heading, but I think something has to happen by the end of 2021. Maybe before Hanukkah, maybe after Hanukkah, maybe early in the new year. We need to pray, okay? Well, anyways, also on another front, there's a couple that was arrested while photographing the residence or the official building in Turkey, an Israeli couple, actually, I think that has produced some advertising commercials. They were arrested. We released the article, but I have late, great breaking news. They are being released from the Turkish prison after 8 days, just like Hanukkah, the miracle. 8 days of lighting the candle, which we're going to start doing soon. We're going to light 8 candles. And the 9th is to light the other ones. More about that next week. All right. So anyways, I want to just share with you some wonderful things that are happening because Israel is on the cutting edge of technology. Technology concerning the COVID vaccines and something through a company called BreLife. So the article is, can Israel's vaccine end the COVID-19 pandemic? I don't know. I'm not a doctor. But I can tell you this, we're continually, depending on wherever we are, mask on, mask off. I'm getting confused by it all. Anyways, what's happening? Israel's COVID-19 vaccine, which has been in trials, could be a game changer for Israel and the rest of the world. Many people were praying that Israel would be on the leading edge of this technology. So here's a quote from one of the doctors, Dr. Jonathan Javitt, CEO of NeuroRx. There is innovation associated with the Israeli vaccine that potentially addresses this terrible virus better than any other technologies. No surprise here. The vaccine candidate was originally developed by the Israel Institute for Biological Research, which operates under the auspices of Prime Minister's office in Israel and works closely with the Defense Ministry. Not sure what it has to do with defense, but I guess defending against plagues and virus is the Defense Ministry. All right, so what else about it? Well, Professor Yossi Karako, director of Hadassah's Clinical Research Unit, who served as the national principal investigator for the trial, said this data should be looked at with precaution, but that it was also very promising. Going on, the BreLife vaccine is based on a platform used by pharmaceutical giant Merck for its Ebola vaccine, meaning it's a platform that has been validated around the world for several years and has been proven both safe and effective. Now, that's interesting to note because many of these other vaccines that were jettisoned out the labs, like mRNA with Moderna or with Pfizer and all that, that was really pushed out very fast. But this BreLife has actually been connected to what the Ebola vaccine process was, so it's been out for a long time. BreLife is a vector-based vaccine. The vaccine takes the vascular stomatitis virus, VSV, and genetically engineers it so it will express the spike protein of the novel coronavirus on its envelope. Just moving down quickly, because I'm not a pharmacist, I'm just presenting the facts to all of you. Because the BreLife vaccine presents the immune system with a somewhat more complete version of the spike protein, this may give the immune system an opportunity to see more targets on the spike protein and therefore target more things on the virus, making it much more effective against variants. That's important. We don't want any vaccine out there that hasn't been properly tested through time and testing. And we also don't want a vaccine that's good for only one variant. Whatever it can catch multiple variants, that's a vaccine in the making. Now, I'm not a proponent against these quickly rushed through vaccinations against COVID-19, but I'm also not against vaccines. So we just have to walk by faith. And whatever choices you yourself make, make in faith and believe God for your healing. So I'd like to say a prayer point. God, we ask that you protect your children and bring the coronavirus pandemic to an end. And as you know, we have many friends who have caught the COVID virus, and we want to pray for your complete healing so that none of you should suffer. In Yeshua's mighty name. Okay, what's the last great breaking news about Israel coming out of Israel from Israel's Technion University in the northern part of Israel, which is rated as one of the best 100 universities of the world? Well, it's that they have developed a molecule that could slow the progress of Alzheimer's disease, according to a report published in last week. One cause of the neurodegenerative disease is an excess of copper ions within cells. When oxidizing agents called free radicals are formed by the copper and amyloid beta complex, you know whatever else I'm trying to say, it may be causing damage to the brain cells. However, removing the copper breaks this substance down, preventing cell death and inhibiting the development of Alzheimer's disease. This is great news because I have a dear mother who's 94 years old, suffering from chronic dementia. Thank God, not defined yet as Alzheimer's. But you know, when you see that in our parents and our loved ones, our grandparents, and even younger people, and you know, I saw a documentary about Glenn Campbell and how he suffered from it. We want to pray for these breakthroughs. You know, God gives each and every one of us, even scientists, even medical professionals, wisdom from on high, knowledge. And so we want to pray that that knowledge and wisdom is directed in a positive energy source way in order to cure these diseases. And I'm so happy when any nation, but especially Israel, makes a breakthrough to save the rest of those people who are suffering, to make life a bit easier. Don't you want to see that? I do. So behold, I will bring to it health and healing, and I will heal them and reveal to them abundance of prosperity and security. So was written by Jeremiah the prophet in the book of Jeremiah 33, verse 6. God bless you all. I want to encourage all of you to watch next week as we dwell a bit more about the lighting of the candles for Hanukkah. Yes, that is the Feast of Dedication. It's mentioned in the Gospels, and we'll talk more about that next week on VFI News. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button link and also ring the bell, and that will help gain more traffic, more algorithms, whatever they call it. And I just love you all. Thank you once again for watching the VFI News from Jerusalem, Israel. This is VFI News and Barry Segal.